Welcome back to embedded system class. So today's lecture I am going to explain about classifications of embedded systems. Embedded systems can be classified into different categories based on the following criteria. So first one is based on generation, second one is based on complexity, third one is based on functionality and performance requirements. So these are the three different categories of embedded systems. So first one is based on generations. So we have four types of generations: first generation, second generation, third generation and fourth generations. Coming to first generation, these embedded systems build around 8-bit microprocessors like 8085 and Z8. So where the first embedded systems invented by the help of 8-bit microcontrollers. Only microcontrollers are available in first generation. So these are simple in hardware circuit with software development in assembly code. So very simple assembly codes are available in first generation. So these generations examples are digital telephone, keypads, stepper motor controllers. So coming to second generation. So here we have along with microprocessor. We have 8-bit microcontroller also. So whatever the core we are using in embedded system, the core is six types. First one is microprocessor, second one is microcontroller, third one is digital signal processor, fourth one is ASICs, application specific ICs, fifth one is CPLDs, complex programmable logic devices, sixth one is FPGAs, field programmable gate array. So we have six types of cores used in embedded systems. So all these generations are based on these cores. In first generations we use microcontrollers, 8-bit microcontrollers. So coming to second generation, in this generation we use 16-bit microprocessors and microcontroller, 8-bit microcontrollers. They are more complex than first generations and powerful than 1GB microprocessor and microcontrollers. So we use this second generation in data acquisition systems, supervisory control and data acquisition systems, right? So in second generation we introduce microcontrollers also. So coming to third generation, a third generation is where we have 32-bit microprocessors and 16-bit microcontrollers along with DSPs and ASICs also available in third generation, right? So in third generation we have DSPs and ASICs also along with microprocessors and microcontrollers. So third generation embedded systems are used in robotics, media, industrial and control processor control and networking. Right, so in third generation along with microprocessor and microcontrollers we have DSPs and ASICs, application specific integrated circuits. So fourth one is fourth generation microcontroller or whatever it may be. So fourth generation is based on microprocessor, microcontroller, DSPs and ASICs. Along with this we have system on chips and reconfigurable processor and multi-core processors are available in fourth generation. Is it clear? So in fourth generations we use microprocessors, microcontrollers, DSPs, ASICs and SOPs and multi-core processors are introduced in fourth generation. So these fourth generation embedded systems are very high performance and very powerful and tight integration. So all these features are available in fourth generations. So these fourth generations embedded systems are used in smartphones, mobile internet devices. These are the four types of generation based embedded systems. Coming to next classification based on complexity, how we can construct the circuit. So first one is small scale, second one is medium scale and third one is large scale or complex. So first one, small scale. So small applications where the performance requirements are not time critical, okay? So here the embedded system will not depends upon time. So built around low performance and low cost, nearly 8-bit or 16-bit microprocessor or microcontrollers. Examples: an electron tie, where electron tie is not depends upon time. So small scale embedded systems are those embedded system will not depends upon time. So coming to second one, medium scale. So here slightly complex in hardware and software requirements compared to small scale, built around minimum performance and low cost, 16-bit or 32-bit microprocessor or microcontrollers. In small scale we use 8 or 16-bit, whereas in medium scale we use 16 or 32-bit microprocessor or microcontroller. And usually contains embedded operating systems, means RTOS are nothing but real-time operating system for functioning. So here medium scale embedded systems are depends upon time also. So examples where we are using examples are industrial applications, monitoring and control of manufacturing equipment. So for third one is large scale or complex. So these are highly complex hardware software. So here we use around 32 or 64 RISC processors or PLDs or SOPs, multi-core processors, right? So reduce instruction set, almost all smartphones or tablets we use RISC processors, reduced instruction set computers, and PLDs, programmable logic device, like CPLDs and FPGAs, or SO system on chips we use large scale. So these are responsible for time critical. So example we use for major fields like mission control applications, like aircraft operating and control systems, electric power systems, we use large scale or complex. So next classification based on functionality and performance, standalone embedded systems, and so these are classified. First one, standalone embedded system. Second one, real time. Third one is network information appliances. Third and fourth one is mobile devices. So coming to first one, standalone. So where we can give the input and we can collect the output. These are all comes under standalone, right? So as the name implies, these systems work in standalone. So they take inputs, process them and produce the outputs. So they have input devices as sensors and output devices are LEDs. All our home appliances like washing machines, refrigerators, microwave ovens, all are example for standalone. So we can give the inputs and we can collect the outputs. So coming to second one, real time. Name itself indicates that these devices are depends upon time, right? Within the time period they have to achieve their deadlines. So a real time should not miss any deadlines for task. So for example, in nuclear plant safety system, missing a deadline may cause loss of life or damage of property. So missile tracking systems, flight control systems, these are all very powerful tasks, right? So if they miss the time, so there is a loss of life or damage of properties in flight control or nuclear plant systems. So real time systems. So third one is network information appliances, means which depends upon internet, right? So in for washing machine we don't need any internet. For operating microwave oven we don't need any internet. Whereas third category, network information appliances, where these embedded system depends upon internet, like weather monitoring system, it continuously monitor the weather. So these are comes under network information appliances. Embedded systems that are provided with network interfaces and accessed by networks such as local area network, LANs and internet, are called network information appliances. Is it clear, guys? So network information appliances are the embedded system. These embedded systems are depends upon internet. So weather monitoring system is an example for this one. So fourth one, mobile devices. We all know that what is mobile devices such as mobile phones, personal digital assistants, PDA, smartphones are special category of embedded system. So mobile phones are capable of supporting high data rate services in addition to voice services. So mobile phones are services like voice services, accessing internet services such as email. We can access services like voice services. We can have emails. We can have we can play online games using mobile phones. But the limitations of mobile devices are small in size, lack of good user interfaces such as full-fledged keyboards and displays, memory constraints, battery lifetime, etc. So these are all limitations of mobile phones. These are the different categories of classifications of embedded systems. Mainly, embedded systems are divided into classified based on generations. There are four types: first generation, second generation, third generation, and fourth generation. Second one, based on complexity, we have three categories: small scale, medium scale, large scale. And third one, based on functionality and performance, we have four types: standalone, real time, network information, and mobile devices. I hope you understood this topic, classification embedded systems. Thank you for watching. So I will explain next topic in the next video. Thank you so much.